everyone, and welcome to MinIO. My name is Mike Johnson, but please call me MJ. In this course, we're going to be installing and upgrading MinIO natively on Linux. What I mean by natively is that we will actually be running from the MinIO binary server package on whichever system you like, specifically on Linux, so RHEL or Debian-based. And at the end of this, you'll be able to hopefully have a really good understanding of how to run these in a production fashion. Again, my name is Mike Johnson. I'm a MinIO training content creator, as well as a DevSecOps engineer by trade. I have 22 years plus in information technology. I've been doing cloud administration for about 10 plus years now, 20 plus years in system administration, and over 6 years in containerization, Docker, and Kubernetes things. So I'm pretty familiar with all of these technologies and have spent far too much time in all of them, but it's been a really great experience, and hopefully I can share some of that with you here in this video course. So who is the target of this course, and also what is the target of this course, or what is the intended outcome? The who of this is that we want to target this as system administrators, DevOps engineers or DevSecOps engineers, and developers who want to be able to stand up their own robust server. So developers would typically be using something ephemeral like Docker image, but I know that some developers really want to work in a production-like environment, so this is targeted at you as well. And the what of this is really to give you the information you need to run a production deployment of MinIO natively on Linux. In this course, we're going to cover downloading the MinIO binary on Linux, running that binary so you can actually see it up and running and how quickly that actually brings it up, configuring and running the MinIO binary with a systemd file, so you can keep this as a persistent process. It will persist through reboots and other things like that, as well as updating the MinIO binary. Updating and maintaining the binary on all of your systems is important day two operation. You don't want to just run with the same binary throughout time, and there will be additional features added, so that's going to be important to understand how to do the upgrade. The intended outcome of this is to really give you, or show you at least, a hands-on installation of this, and sort of a complement to the docs, which we'll be using heavily in this course. The docs obviously provide step-by-step instructions, but we wanted to show you those instructions as well. Hopefully at the end of this, you're going to be able to emulate what I've done here and get this up and running successfully on your systems. Additionally, it's important to think about how you're going to deploy this at scale when you start really deploying this into multiple environments in your organization. And so with this knowledge that you get in this video course, you should also be able to plug this into whatever automation platform you use, whether it be Ansible or Chef or whatever it is, and simply running those different playbooks and things to bring these servers up repeatedly and reliably every single time and really have a robust production deployment of all these systems. Here's some links that I recommend you visit. We will be following heavily the MinIO documentation. Obviously, this video and this series is a point in time, so some of these docs may change. So I highly recommend that anytime you go to do this or you're looking for additional information, that you go check the docs to make sure they haven't been updated with newer information than is in this video. And also you can follow along on the GitHub pages and the GitHub repository for MinIO. You can check out all the new releases and any additional information that we provide there. Let's jump right in. So in section one, we're going to talk about downloading the MinIO binaries onto your Linux systems. There are a couple different ways that you can do that. The MinIO package is available for OS-specific packages. So if you're running RHEL, there's an RPM for it. And if you're running a Debian-based system like Ubuntu or even Debian, you can run a .deb package to install it there. There's also a binary available. There's a couple extra steps when you're installing the binary. You need to make it executable and move it to something in your system path so that you can easily call that binary. But we will be showing that off today as well. The Debian install, we will simply be running the wget command to download from the MinIO download site. Same goes for RHEL. And then I'll actually show you how to download the binary, just generic binary as well. And I'm actually going to show you that in a lab here soon, so don't worry too much about this information. Also, there'll be links in the description to all of the docs that show you how to do this exactly. So let's jump into the lab and we will actually show off installing these on the various types of systems. Before I jump into the labs, I did want to show you the docs page, so you can visit min.io docs /minio/linux, and you'll get to the index page there. And again, I really highly encourage you to follow along with these docs. And if you're looking for a solid reference, don't use the video, use this page. As I said, this information will be updated much more often than any of the videos in the series will be. So if you go to this page and click on the Linux tab, if you happen not to land here, you will see all of the instructions and notes and additional quick start items here. But what we really care about is the procedure for installing this. And so installing the MinIO server, you can see here that there are all the versions that I mentioned, RPM, deb, and the native binary. And then it will also show you how to launch the MinIO server, creating a simple directory for MinIO to store all the information that you upload into it, as well as give you information on accessing that host. And so we'll go ahead and follow along with this. So let's jump over to the labs now. All right, so here we are on our lab servers. You'll notice I have three lab servers here. I have an Ubuntu instance, a Rocky instance, which is basically a RHEL-based or CentOS-alike system, and also just a generic Debian instance. I'm going to show you how to install the MinIO binary on all three of these. And then throughout the rest of the course, we'll actually be working off the Ubuntu instance mostly to do all of the demos for bringing the server up and modifying the systemd file and things like that. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to install the minio.deb package on Ubuntu. So we'll go ahead and run this command. Again, these are directly from the doc, so you can go ahead and feel free to run these as well. You can see that it's a very small binary. It's less than 100 megs, and so it downloads very quickly. And if we do rich minio, you can see that it's installed itself in user local bin minio, so it's available in your path automatically. We'll go ahead and do the same on our, in this case, Rocky instance. Again, the command is very similar, directly from the docs. And it's just as quick. You do have to confirm that you actually want to install that. And again, it installs to the same location, user local bin minio. The last one's just slightly different, but not too much. We will be downloading the generic binary from the site. So we'll run this command here. If you run an ls, you can see that it's here, but it's not actually executable yet. If you look here, it just has read write, but no x. So next we need to run a chmod plus x minio. And now if we look at that file again, we'll see that it's now green and it has the executable flag in there. And last thing we need to do is move that into our system path. In this case, we're going to move it into user local bin. Now, if I run which minio, you can see that it's at the same location as the others. So there you have it. Hopefully that gives you a really good idea of how easy it is to get minio binaries installed on your Linux systems. Pretty straightforward. In the next section, we'll actually talk about running minio and how you can get that up and running on your system, and actually start using the MinIO UI and the MinIO client. So check out that video out, and thanks for watching.